Hi everyone, I am Dr. Anisha and I welcome you to my channel. In the last video, we discussed about two inflammatory odontogenic cysts, and today I shall be dealing with the non-odontogenic cyst. In this, I shall be covering the developmental ones first and then we shall progress with the inflammatory ones. But before starting the discussion, I would like you to kindly subscribe my channel for further videos. As I told you, we are going to start with the non-odontogenic cysts now. So let us start by knowing what are non-odontogenic cysts. So firstly, ये जो non-odontogenic cyst है, आपको नाम से समझ में आ रहा होगा. The word is non, that means it is not derived or not related to any kind of odontogenic apparatus. All right. So non-odontogenic cysts are basically not essentially derived or related to any odontogenic apparatus, and so they are known as non-odontogenic cyst. Jaise ki humne odontogenic cyst mein we studied the derivation, like from where these cysts are gonna arise, like for example the remnants of dental lamina, the remnants of your cell rests of serrae, cell rests of malleses. But in non-odontogenic cyst, these cysts are not derived or related to any kind of odontogenic apparatus. So this is the first point about your non-odontogenic cyst. Now when I talk about the types, I told you they have got two types. Firstly, jo pehla category hoga, that will be your developmental non-odontogenic cyst, which are mainly your true cyst, alright. And your second category will be your inflammatory non-odontogenic cyst, in which there are few pseudocysts also. Alright, so this was a very brief introduction about your non-odontogenic cyst. Now starting with the developmental kind of non-odontogenic cyst, if I give you a very brief introduction about the same, so they are basically the fissural cysts which arise at the line of fusion. Alright, so basically number of different types of fissural cysts occur in the jawbone, arising and have generally been considered arising along the line of fusion of various bones and embryonic processes. Agar main aapko diagram ke help se, if I explain you, so what happens is, for example, this is your one, bone. This is your another bone. Agar inka jab union hoga, aur tab yahan pe ek epithelial lining entrap ho jayegi, to ek fissural cyst ka development hoga, and that will be categorized under your developmental odontogenic cyst. So it can be a bony union or it can be the union of two embryonic processes, but the most important point to be kept in mind is jab aapka fusion hoga, to there will be entrapment of some epithelial lining, okay, and that lining will certainly give rise to a cyst. All right, so these kind of fissural cysts are basically included in the developmental non-odontogenic cyst category. Now if I talk about the source of epithelium, I told you since yahan pe entrapment ek epithelial lining ki hoti hai, to ye jo aapka epithelium hoga of the cyst, this is gonna get derived from the epithelial cells entrapped between the processes. I already told you these are your processes or the bones which are gonna fuse. So what happens is, jab inka fusion hota rahega, at that moment or at that point of time, jab yahan pe epithelial lining entrap ho jayegi, so there will be formation of a cyst which is known as fissural cyst. We are gonna study different kinds of fissural cysts in the upcoming videos. So this cyst will have the epithelial lining derived from the epithelium which was entrapped between the processes. So this was a very brief introduction about the developmental non-odontogenic cyst. And now we shall be starting with different kinds of non-odontogenic cysts which are developmental in origin. And the first cyst which we are going to cover is an intraosseous developmental non-odontogenic cyst, which is your nasopalatine duct cyst. So the first cyst jiske baare mein hum discuss karenge, that will be your nasopalatine duct cyst, under the category of intraosseous developmental non-odontogenic cyst. अगर मैं इसके दूसरे टर्म्स की बात करूं, तो फर्स्टली इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज नेजोपैलेटाइन कैनाल सिस्ट. ऑलराइट, नाम से समझ में आएगा आपको, नेजोपैलेटाइन जो डक्ट होगा उसके यू नो इनसाइड द सिस्ट विच डेवलप्स विद इन द नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट विल बी योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट. ऑलराइट, so again the other term which we use is your nasopalatine canal. The canal is the other word for your duct, so the name is your nasopalatine canal cyst. Now the third term which we are going to study is your incisive canal cyst. All right, and finally it is also known as median anterior maxillary cyst. Agar main is you know term ko dhyan se agar dekhu to the word is your median, that means the location will be approximately median to your jaw. Okay, now it is also located anteriorly in the jaw and mainly it affects your, obviously it is going to affect your maxillary jaw, so that is why the name is your median anterior maxillary cyst. तो अगर मैं इसके इंट्रोडक्शन की बात करूं, तो फर्स्टली ये जो आपका नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट है, दैट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन नॉन ओडोंटोजेनिक सिस्ट. ऑलराइट, एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट इज बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इज, ये जो आपका नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट है ये बेसिकली डीजेनरेट कर जाता है, यू नो बेसिकली इट अंडरगोज योर प्रोग्रेसिव डीजेनरेशन, बट जो आपका एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग है अगर वो परसिस्ट कर गया, द परसिस्टेंस ऑफ एपिथेलियल रेमिनेंट्स मे लेटर बिकम द सोर्स ऑफ एपिथेलिया दैट गिव राइज टू योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट. आई विल अगेन रिपीट इन अ वेरी सिंपलर वर्ड, इफ आई एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट हैपेंस इज, एक नॉर्मल प्रोसेस में जो आपका नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट है यूजुअली वो डीजेनरेट हो जाता है, वो परसिस्ट नहीं करता है, बट अगर इसका जो एपिथेलियल रेमिनेंट है वो यू नो परसिस्ट कर गया या फिर वो रह गया किसी वजह से, तो दैट इज गोना गिव राइज टू अ सिस्ट विच इज नोन एज योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट. सो बेसिकली दिस वॉज द यू नो बेसिकली द पैथोजेनेसिस बाय विच योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट अकर्स इन द रीजन. ओके, नाउ योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट कैन फॉर्म विद इन द इंसिसिव कैनाल. अगर मैं इसके लोकेशंस की बात करूँ तो डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ लोकेशन में ये परसिस्ट हो सकता है. फर्स्टली इट कैन यू नो अपियर और अकर इन योर इंसिसिव कैनाल, ओके, विच इज लोकेटेड इन द पैलेटाइन बोन and behind the alveolar process of maxillary central incisors. Okay, जो आपका incisive canal होगा of the palatine bone, वहाँ पर यह persist कर सकता है. It can, you know, occur behind the alveolar process, okay, of maxillary central incisor. Okay, now this is the reason why the name median anterior maxillary cyst has been given, maybe. Okay, since it occurs behind the maxillary central incisor, तो इसीलिए इसका टर्म जो हम यूज करते हैं दैट इज योर मीडियन एंटीरियर मैक्सिलरी सिस्ट. ओके, एंड फाइनली इन द सॉफ्ट टिश्यू ऑफ द पैलेट, सॉफ्ट टिश्यू ऑफ द पैलेट. ओके, सो दीज आर द प्रोबेबल लोकेशंस एट विच योर नेजोपैलेटाइन डक्ट सिस्ट मे अकर. सो इट कैन बी योर इंसिसिव कैनाल विच इज लोकेटेड इन द पैलेटाइन बोन एंड बिहाइंड द एल्वियोलर प्रोसेस ऑफ मैक्सिलरी सेंट्रल इंसाइजर एंड फाइनली इन द सॉफ्ट टिश्यू ऑफ द पैलेट. Now the cysts of incisive papilla. Okay, so this was the brief introduction about your nasopalatine duct cyst. Now coming to the etiology of the nasopalatine duct cyst. So basically the causes are trauma, infection and mucus retention. Alright, and also the spontaneous cystic degeneration of the residual ductal epithelium is most likely the etiology. Alright. Now coming to the clinical features, अगर मैं gender predilection की बात करूँ तो basically males are 18 times more affected than females. So basically mostly seen in you know males. Okay. Now when I talk about the gender, it has got a very wide range and 8 to 84 years of you know patients have been reported of nasopalatine duct cyst. अगेन व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट द क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स, तो क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स में अगर मैं स्मॉल सिस्ट की बात करूं तो बेसिकली दे आर एसिम्टोमेटिक, बट अगर मैं लार्ज सिस्ट की बात करूं तो बेसिकली वैरायटी ऑफ सिम्टम्स इंक्लूड एंड दे आर स्वेलिंग, डिस्चार्ज एंड पेन. ओके, सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द टाइप ऑफ डिस्चार्ज विच यू नो अकर्स फ्रॉम दिस सिस्ट, इट इज़ अ वेरी सॉल्टी टेस्ट इन माउथ एंड डीवाइटलाइजेशन ऑफ पल्प ऑल्सो एसोसिएटेड टीथ हैज़ बीन रिपोर्टेड. सो जो आपका लाइक सिस्ट का जो डिस्चार्ज होगा दैट इज गोइंग टू बी सॉल्टी इन टेस्ट. ओके, एंड ऑल्सो द यू नो अफेक्टेड पल्प ऑफ द टूथ इज डीवाइटलाइज्ड. ओके, एंड द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट सेज जो आपका लार्ज सिस्ट होगा दैट इज गोइंग टू परफोरेट द लेबियल एंड द पैलेटल बोनी प्लेट्स. ओके, एंड ऑल्सो जो आपका लार्ज सिस्ट होगा दैट इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्वियसली यू नो एक्सपैंड, सिंस इट इज यू नो लार्जर इन साइज, इट इज गोइंग टू एक्सपैंड एंड परफोरेट द बोनी प्लेट्स ऑफ योर लेबियल एंड पैलेटल साइड्स. ऑल राइट, ऑल्सो देयर विल बी अ फ्लक्चुएंट स्वेलिंग ऑफ द एंटीरियर पैलेट. Okay, now when I talk about the location, I already told you basically it affects the midline anterior maxilla. There will be a apparent discoloration of the cyst due to the accumulation of fluid content. Okay, and finally the tooth displacement and bony expansion is seen sometimes. Obviously, when the cyst is large, when the cyst will be large, there will be expansion, there will be perforation of the bony plates, and of course due to that there will be tooth displacement will be seen sometimes. Okay, so this was all about your clinical features of nasopalatine duct cyst. Now talking about the histological features of your nasopalatine duct cyst, like any other cyst, this cyst is also going to be lined by, you know, epithelial cells and surrounded by the connective tissue wall. Okay, now your nasopalatine duct cyst will have squamous, columnar, cuboidal cells or some combination of these kind of epithelial cells depending upon the location. All right. अगर मैं इसके एपिथेलियल सेल्स के टाइप की बात करूं, तो इट कैन हैव स्क्वामस सेल्स, इट कैन हैव क्यूबॉइडल सेल्स, इट कैन हैव कॉलमनर सेल्स एंड ऑल्सो अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज काइंड ऑफ सेल्स. नाउ दिस विल डिपेंड अपॉन द लोकेशन एज आई टोल्ड यू. इफ द सिस्ट हैज बीन डेराइव्ड फ्रॉम सम एपिथेलियल लाइनिंग विच अकर्स और गेट्स इंट्रैप्ड बिटवीन द एम्ब्रियोनिक प्रोसेसेस, नाउ दैट विल रिफ्लेक्ट the type of pluripotency of the embryonic epithelial remnants. Okay, so basically jo aapka cell type hoga that will gonna reflect what kind of embryonic epithelial remnant was present, all right, which was entrapped between the embryonic processes. Okay, and the next point says agar main chronic inflammatory cell reaction ki baat karu to it says it consists of lymphocytes and plasma cells which is observed in the cystic wall. Jo aapka cystic wall hoga usme aapka chronic inflammatory cell reaction in the in the form of your lymphocytes and plasma cells will be present in the your cystic wall. Now the presence of structural elements in the cystic wall that are native to the nasopalatine canal are also present. Jo bhi structural element aapka nasopalatine canal mein, you know, it is present, they are also they also occur in your cystic wall. Okay, now the next point says 71 cases have been reported with the presence of hemorrhage. And finally, the cystic fluid is straw colored. तो अगर मैं cystic fluid की बात करूँ तो cystic fluid is straw colored and contains erythrocytes, desquamated epithelial cells, leukocytes, tissue debris and bacteria. So basically these were the points which we, you know, study under histological features. And with this we are done with your histological features of your nasopalatine duct cyst. And lastly, agar main treatment ki baat karu, to basically enucleation of the cyst via palatal or buccal approach is usually done. Jo aapka treatment hoga usme hum enucleation karenge, that too via palatal or buccal approach. And finally this can be, you know, treated. Okay, so this was all about your nasopalatine duct cyst. Now the next cyst which we are going to cover is your median palatal cyst. नाम से समझ में आ रहा है, मीडियन विल बी और यू नो समवेयर इन द मिडलाइन. Now your palatal says it is going to be in the palate, okay? So if I talk about the etiology of the cyst, so basically it, you know, forms, it is a fissural cyst, so it forms by the epithelial entrapment in between the, you know, fusion or the line of fusion of the palatal process and the maxilla. Like if I draw the diagram, what happens is when the maxilla, you know, and the palatal process, they join or, you know, they fuse with each other, there is an entrapment of epithelial cells, and these epithelial cells will, you know, give rise to your median palatal cyst. Okay, now when I talk about the clinical feature of median palatal cyst, so firstly we'll talk about the location, and as I said, location will be your midline of hard palate between the lateral palatal processes. Okay, they may become larger over a prolonged period of time and produce definite palatal swelling. Okay, so if I talk about the size of the median palatal cyst, so basically with prolonged time it will, you know, increase in size, it will become large, and then finally it will produce a palatal swelling. Okay, so this was all about the size. If I talk about the radiological features, so basically on the palatal radiograph it will look a well circumscribed radiolucent area, okay, which will be opposite to the bicuspid or the molar region, and it will also have a sclerotic border. Okay, so there will be a sclerotic layer of the bone which will border around the median palatal cyst. Okay, so this was all about the radiological features of your median palatal cyst. Now talking about the histological features of your median palatal cyst, so again it will have an epithelial lining along with a dense fibrous band of connective tissue. Okay, so if I talk about the type of cells of the epithelial lining, so basically it is going to be stratified squamous epithelium, okay, and occasionally it can also be lined by pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Okay, now the overlying you know, dense fibrous band of connective tissue will be present along with chronic inflammatory cell infiltration. Okay, so this was all about the histological features of your median palatal cyst. Now if I talk about the treatment, again surgical removal and thorough curettage is to be done, you know, so as to treat your median palatal cyst. So this was all about the two major cysts which we study under your intraosseous developmental non-odontogenic cyst, which are your median palatal cyst, and the other one was your nasopalatine duct cyst. So this was all for now. If you liked the video, do like and share. If you have any doubts, you can get back to me in the comment section. Thank you so much.